Earlier today, I spoke with a forensic expert who told me that obtaining a partial DNA profile in a criminal case is very common, but she explained to me why they are hard to narrow down to just one person.
We heard it several times on Friday.
It's a partial Y profile. Whose partial DNA profile? It's a partial profile.
But what exactly is a partial DNA profile?
A partial DNA profile is when the DNA areas that are being targeted for DNA, a complete profile has not been obtained.
On Friday, the district attorney said that a partial profile from a male DNA was found on Victoria Martins's back, but they haven't been able to match it up to anybody yet. Everhart says that this type of testing the DA's office is probably referring to is YSTR testing, which is a type of DNA testing that focuses on the male chromosomes. She says that linking someone to a partial profile is difficult.
Again, this is a profile that is not unique to the individual. However, it does narrow down maybe that family, but also you have to take into consideration if anybody had ever been adopted.
Everhart says that these partial profiles aren't entered into the national database because they aren't unique to just one person. They are unique to someone's parental line, but that makes it really hard to narrow down to just one person.
Typically in samples where there could be a lot of female DNA, it can mask the minimal amount of DNA. It can mask that DNA profile and you can't see it.
And right now, one of the only ways to identify a partial DNA profile is going to be through buccal swab testing, which is usually done by collecting cells from inside a person's cheek. For Target 7, Marissa Armas, KOAT Action 7 News.